Hi, it's Kamilla with DesignSpark. In this video, we're going to be unboxing not one, but two products from Cypress, including SY8C kit inductive sensing evaluation kit, as well as SY8C kit 148 coil inductive sensing coil breakout board. And these products together enable programming and debugging of PSoC 4700 family of microcontrollers, as well as experience advanced capabilities of MagSense inductive sensing solution. I hope you like this video, and if you want to see more from DesignSpark, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. And let's get started on the video. Let's have a closer look at the components on the board. To start with, the board features the PSoC 4700S MCU based on ARM Cortex M0 Plus with up to 32 GB flash and 4 GB of SRAM. The Cypress PSoC 5LP device is used to implement the KitProc 2 onboard programmer and debugger with USB UART, USB I2C, and USB SPI bridge functionalities. Three inductive sensing button coils are provided on the kit. To evaluate the button coils, a metal overlay has been placed on top of them. The onboard LED 1, 2, and 3 can be used to display outputs from the PSoC 4700S device. An inductive sensing proximity coil is provided to demonstrate the inductive sensing proximity functionality of the PSoC 4700S device. To demonstrate this feature, a metal target is provided along with the kit. The proximity sensor is triggered at around 2 cm distance from the coil. And lastly, the board features programming and debugging header, USB Type-C connector, I/O header, FPC connector, and a communication header. The FPC connector can be used to establish the connection between the SYC kit 148 coil kit and the SY8C kit 148 baseboard. So I have these two products in front of me. We're gonna unbox both of them today. Let me start with the evaluation kit. So when you order this box from us, you'll get the following things inside. So you have this quick start guide, the board itself. You will get USB type A to type C cable and a metal target that we're actually going to use for our demo later. So let's try and power up our board. I'm going to use the cable that has been provided with the kit. And I'm actually going to use my laptop to power this device. You'll see that the power is connected. This LED is on. Let's use our metal target to detect the proximity. So as you'll see, the closer I move the target to the coil, the LEDs light up and you can measure the distance. We can also test the buttons. So when I press this button, you'll see that the LED lights up. So this main board has the proximity sensor as well as three buttons. But if you think that is not enough for your design and you want to test out other coils, you can purchase this breakout board from us. I'm gonna open the this package and see what's inside. So the breakout board comes with FPC cable that can be used to connect this additional coil sensors to the main evaluation kit. In the board, You have various sensors and the four metal targets, including this one, which is a rotary target, looks like this. But then you also have three more metal targets that are part of the board, and you have to break them to be able to use with the sensors. Please follow the instructions in the datasheet, because you have to be extra careful and not break the FPC wiring here. As you can see, if you're not very careful, the linear encoders might be separated from the FPC connection. Speaking of FPC connection, the board has two FPC connectors, one here and then the other one here. Let's have a look, closer look at the coils that are available on the board. So you have seven multi-purpose sensors, including CR1, CR2, CR3 here, and CR4, CR5, SQ7, and SQ8. On top of that, you have two linear encoders here. You have rotary encoder here. And you have 6-segment slider. So one thing to note is that not all of the coil sensors are connected through FPC connection. Some of them you'll have to use headers, and you have to connect them through the wire to the main board. Please again follow the instructions in the datasheet for individual sensors. So in the last section of the video, let's just sum up all the use cases for MagSense technology and what you can do with these two products. Well, first of all, the obvious answer could be you could create buttons. So you could have your coil and then have a metal overlay on top and create your inductive buttons, which would be more resistant to dust and water and all the other particles that might be present in the industrial environment. On top of that, you could use this technology for detecting the proximity, so you could use metal detector for that. And then the other use cases could be rotary encoders as well as linear encoders. So as you can see, you can do so much. So try these two products. You could get away with just the evaluation kit if you are focusing on proximity detection, as well as you want to test out the buttons. That the evaluation kit should be enough. But if you want to go and explore the all the other existing coil sensors, feel free to buy the breakout board. We hope that you liked this video, and if you have any suggestions for future videos, or if you want us to do a project with this product, leave the comments below and we'll get back to you. Thank you so much. See you next time.